Hi, this is Siddharth Deshmukh. Welcome to another episode of Sportsy. Let's talk sports. Today we'll be talking about not sports, but the allied industry of sports, which is a big feeder to us, which is fitness industry. And if I have to talk about fitness industry, I'm privileged to talk to somebody who is known as the father of Indian fitness or the grandfather of Indian fitness industry. The first gym they started in 1932 and moved on to there, make a commercial property out of the gyms in 1962 and it's been running for the last 59 years. He's an 87-year-old, youngest person I know and ever fit, ever charming, Talwalkar sir. Hello, sir. Yes. Good to have you on our platform, Sportsy, Let's Talk Sports. And you can't believe how happy I am to interview an 87-year-old young guy who is known to be the father of Indian fitness industry. And it's a legacy of Talwalkar's from, I think it started in 1932. And then you made into commercial model in for last 5 to 6 decades now. When everybody looks up to you as a father of Indian fitness industry, how do you think the fitness industry has evolved that you have seen? You have seen the maximum. How do you think it has evolved?
Yes. What happens? They call me father just because I'm the eldest living active person in this fitness industry. Actually, it is started by my father, as you said, 1932. So it is about 88 years we are going on. And this is the only institution, it is a personal institution, individual, a family institution, working for 88 years in the country is not a easy thing or it is something different. But there are, you'll surprise that other gyms are there, but they're all mandals. Mandals are some committees, mandals, they are older than us. There are 3-4 existing in Bombay itself. One where my father got a job first, that institution is still there in Girgaum. There is one in Bandra, 123 years old.
Wow.
There are. And Calcutta, there are few. But my father's time, my father was individual person, it was not mandal. And former gyms were typical. This is what a small area, 600-700 square feet, in between an akhada and one Malkham standing, and few weight dun stand, deep stand, mirrors, small mirrors, and that Hanuman Murthy. This was supposed to be a gym, and lot of people doing in the mud also, that are there doing by tug, this, and some people on that Malkham at one place, and trainer. It was a wonderful gym. I have seen those gyms because my father started teaching there when I was young, but. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you, I was born in 1933 and gym was started in 32.
Right.
Little I would like to talk about name.
Right.
It's something people will like it. My father named that gym, his first gym in 1932, which is started in Khar locality. Khar. It was little away from Mumbai that time. It's far away, less population. But he got a place. He named it that Ramakrishna Vyam Mandir. His father's name, my grandfather,
okay.
Ramakrishna Vyam Mandir. And in English, I was surprised. The board was, afterwards I've seen, I remember, Ramakrishna Physical Culture Institution. In Marathi, Ramakrishna Vyam Mandir. In English, because that was British period, Ramakrishna Physical Culture Institution. But with the time when I became about 7-8 years old, that means 40 time, he changed that name he gave the English name that time. New Physical Culture Home,
okay.
NPCH. I remember that time when I became 10 afterwards, I used to do some pyramids on my father's hand on the top pyramid. But we used to have banyan, New Physical Culture Home, that logo. I remember that, New Physical Culture Home. I was a very thin, short, I'm 5'4 only, but thin. Thin boy, inferiority complex. Up to 25 of my age, I never did exercise. Though my father was well known, he never used to like. But you'll surprise the punishment used to, if I fail. I used to fail sometimes. English, fail, quarterly exam, half yearly exam, mathematics sometimes. Even sometimes in Marathi subject, red line. So punishment used to be, you know what? Madhukar will go early morning, open the gym for 15 days, for 1 month, like that. Bapre at that age to get up early, go to the gym, 5 o'clock opening. So get up and come back at 8:30, go to school afterwards, 10:30, 11 o'clock. It was my punishment. And my teachers, I used to go there and sit on the stool, thin boy, short. They used to tapli mat, they used to do like that. Father ka naam kharab karne wala hai. He will not come up in the life. Aisa rehne wala hai. Like that, they used to say. I also used to accept all those things. But when I became little elder, I start, and at the age of, I became, my mother's student, gym line is not good. My father's student said, do exercise. Mother's student, don't do exercise. So I took both the chances. No study also much, no exercise also. But still, I was good at studies. I became a textile engineer.
Yes.
From VJTI. I got a job in Khata Mills. At that time, I was about 23, 25. 2 years, I didn't do it. But in that mill, there used to have scale. Every department, how much cotton we have. I'm textile, no? So how much yarn is there, we used to weigh. So I used to stand on that scale and just check my weight. I used to be, that time it was in pounds. I used to be about 98, 99 pounds, 5'4" height, like so low. Then one day, really, I felt it was 1st August 1958. I remember it was Tilak Jayanti. Somebody had told me Tilak has taken that war and he has started exercise. So I said, I will start exercise. Really, I started very seriously, not because of my father or my mother, inside, from inside. And I took 4 years, 1960, that means within 2 years. I took part in Mr. Bombay from 99 pounds to a good muscular body weight, about 155 pounds. Wow. That is about 70 kg. 45 to 70 kg. I increased the weight, good body, good color. I have that thing. I started looking better. Then that time, I started afterwards. I also must start my father's footstep. I should start my own gym. When I was working, then in 1962, one day you please take my interview, how I got this place, who helped me, how the God was kind to me, that I'll tell you details. Every stage is surprise. I got a place at Linking Road. My father's gym was not there that time. It was shifted long. It is 30 years gap.
Right.
It was shifted to Chani Road. That branch is still there, oldest. We have. That time, I'll tell you name I'm talking. I wanted to say new physical club, second branch. Like that. I talked to my father that I'm starting. He said, no, please don't take my interference. You don't interfere. I won't interfere. We'll help each other. You change your name. Then I was thinking, what name should I give? Father says, no new physical culture home. But when I was teaching and father gym part-time, I used to do Khata Mills. Mills and evening I used to go to, or morning shift wise, I go to father's gym because I was fond of good physique, exercise, teaching. My really father taught me how to teach, how to take measurements, really, how to give exercises, how to plan the workout. That time, old time, old days, but I learned a lot from him.
Right.
And when I started it, then, but members, they used to talk to me, you know. They never should say, we go to a new physical culture home. Just to be, I'm a Talwalkar ankade jato. We go to Talwalkar's. Just to, that idea I got, and I gave the name. It was 15 July 1962. That's about 58 years back. It is 58 years back. Wow. About. I gave the name, first board, Talwalkar Gymnasium. And in between, you may not know, there was bodybuilder's photo. John Gray was world champion that time. But you will surprise there also. After about 2 years, I started ladies class after 1 year.
Yes.
And I got only 2-3 ladies. Of course, it was 3 days a week, 10 to 12. Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, 10 to 12 ladies. Monday, Wednesday, Friday was kept my own for my own exercise after 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
So then one lady told me, sir, that bodybuilder photo, na, it is telling ladies that they'll become like them. It's old story. Sir, remove that. I put only the workers. Really, I changed. I removed that bodybuilder and both design also slightly changed, and I started getting ladies. And today also, I think we have got the highest number of women coming to the workout compared to any other gym. That time also, it is faith of security also, of improving, better treatment, better everything, service, better service to them. So it is like that. So the Tawalkar name has now, after 58 or 50 years, I never thought that it will become a biggest brand. And now if you see like that, there is no second name. Just Siddharth. You tell me which is second name. Don't take gold and this is the foreign franchises.
The franchises, yes.
I'm talking Indian brand. There's no second.
Correct.
Now, my friend Abhimanyu is having 8-10 branches, but there is no brand in the country.
Correct.
No brand as a, it's only Tawalkar. So I'm proud of that also.
Yes, sir.
Like that. And I'm going to strive for it.
Yes. And so I think that shows the how the you yourself may mention, I know, as a marketeer myself, I was looking at something that you mentioned, from the naming to branding to changing the perception about removing the logo.
Yes.
That woman becoming you're as good as a brand consultant to tell you that, okay, remove that guy for women to get more advertising.
Of course, they'll be shocked. You'll be surprised. Then marketing, you said, my first two advertisement in Diwali was done by Balasaheb Thackeray cartoons.
Oh, wow.
First two cartoons. He was a simple man, ordinary man with a pajama and banyan. He called me his house and he did two cartoons for me. That time.
Excellent.
1962 or 63, that time.
Sir, in last 58 years, have you seen the fitness as becoming a lifestyle now? Or it is still something that people are still not taking it seriously?
See, it has increased, but the you know, when I was small, when I started gymnasium, the population of 55 crores, Bombay, now it has become 130 crores. And when I was in college, there I remember the song also, Charge is a Koti, Navjavan, Asa Gana Hotam, sir. That means whole India's population 40 crores.
Yeah.
And in Bombay was about 30-35 lakhs. So that percentage-wise, number has increased, but I think percentage has not increased to that extent. But talking, thinking has increased.
Right.
Actually, to bring it into practice, people are still lazy or ignorant or taking their health for granted. And I don't know, no time, various reasons they give. But it has not increased to that. For your information, at present, total average of people going to the gym paying fees in India, it is 0.08 or 0.1, total India. Cities like Bombay, Delhi, Calcutta, Chennai, Bangalore, they're slightly about 2-3% people of the population. They go to gym, pay the fees and do exercise. And that 2-3% people, they do at home. They might be yoga, might be mat, they're doing push-up, pull-ups at home, something, somebody buying something, a cycle, stationary cycle, they do at home. And 2-3% till younger age, they're playing games, sports, games, like that. So about 6-8% people are taking little care. 92-93% people don't do anything and they live. They don't think that they are unhappy, but leave this world very early. For your example, the people, those 60 years, those they were born, today only 11.5% are remaining.
Yes.
See, 60 years old, those were born 60 years back, today only 11.5% are there. Now, my age, 87, yesterday was I wanted to see the world average. I've just completed 60 years of my marriage also, on 7th May, like that. So I was, marriage, less than 1%, 1.5, on the whole world. Wow. Those are 60 years, of course, might be major reason, broken up marriage also, but existing 60 people, so low average. So you say it has gone up, sale has gone up, equipment sale has gone up. Yes, but percentage-wise, I don't think so. It might have gone 0.5 or something. Right. It must have gone up.
But sir, do you think it is because of sports fitness is the industry which is an inflow for sports, or sports becomes they go hand in hand, health, fitness, and sports go very hand in hand. And is it because we do not have a sporting culture? Like the PT teacher is the most neglected teacher in the school. Is it because of the physical education or the fitness education is not cultivated at the grassroots level? Is that the reason that after some time also we don't take it seriously?
You can say this is one of the reasons and one of the points, but that laziness, inactivity. And you're talking about so many people died in corona, so many died of heart attack, so many blood pressure. But biggest disease in this world is inactivity.
Yes.
People die, but they take it for granted. That is the thing. I walk. Walk means don't walk. I do yoga. I mean, just lie down, pranayama and shavasana. But I always tell people, this exercise must be felt in you. It must be seen in you. Your walk, your talk, your posture, it should be seen in you. Yogi, you should look like a yogi then. If you are a cyclist, you should look like an athlete. Jogger, then you should like an athlete. Men, women, both. But yogi, where I see them do yoga, they don't. They quarrel at home, they use anywhere and do yoga. It should be seen. And what happened? These words are exercise words now. It is a complicated, it is like a punishment. They feel like that. So that's why still people are not attracted. Exertion. People are not for it. I want to find a good word for it. Vam. In Marathi also, vam. So it's a difficult word. Like that.
Yes.
So again, there are other problems. Money problem might be there, time problem there, but they can do at home.
Yeah,
everybody can become healthy and good physique in no time.
I think the biggest problem is the excuse.
Yeah, excuse.
And
taking life for granted.
Yes, exactly. Hopefully, what we are seeing once in a lifetime kind of pandemic right now. I hope people will take it very seriously and start focusing.
The diseases.
Yes.
Now, I would like to say about nice thing. See, yes. Some people tell me, sir, I'm diabetic. As if it is there some PhD or something like that. The way they talk. Sir, I'm diabetic. Please take care while you are joining. See, how they take it like that.
Okay. I don't know, sir. You can put people... completely off words. I think I've completely forgot my next question. Okay. The secret of your fit and charming life.
Yeah. See, what happened when I started this gym, in this life, I started feeling full of confidence because of good body, good people starring me. Before they were hating me, I was thin, short, inferiority complex. After 4 years, and when I after started gym, I'm confident, started talking to members, so many people coming in contact. And that time I have said, still I pray every day, I want to become the richest person in fitness industry, fitness icon, best bodied person at my age. At that age, I must be a best bodied person, nice and kind person, and handsomest person in the fitness industry. Wow. And for each every point, I'm working on it for last so many years. So I take care to earn money. I take care to look nice, charm. I do exercise. I eat properly. They come. But I've got a habit of overcoming that also. And I'm on the whole, my family is good. My brothers, my sisters, they help me. My family, my wife, my children, my friend, Bodybuilding Association. I'm the founder of the Bodybuilding Association also, this India. Now I'm not a president because above 70, they don't. Now the government has put restrictions. Yeah. So I'm still the founder member of our Indian Bodybuilding bodybuilding federation. So I'm in contact with all healthy bodybuilders, and now you know UHFF, your Vipul friend. I am one of the founders there also. We are coming together. So all that, my friend, they helped me to become nicer, healthier, that feeling of well-being and acceptance.
Right.
And taking care every step. I stand straight. I sit straight. I just, in my gym, I'm always erect. I look after them. My chest out, stomach in, chest out, chin up. I take care in everything. My face, my hair, my skin. I take all the care. Without care, it's not possible.
So I think you said a very, what I can put, you have to love yourself a lot.
Yeah, I forgot to tell you. Unknowingly, I love so much myself, people may not like it.
it's your life, and because of loving yourself, you're not causing harm to anybody. I think that's the possible.
And love is not that, and love is such a thing that at a time you can love 100 things.
Yes.
Love is not, you can love I can love my wife, I love my son different, I can love my friends, I can love my profession, I can love myself, I can love the cloth, whatever it may be. Love is a different thing.
Yes.
At the time you can.
So now from the gym, usually gymming is related to, one is fitness and one is bodybuilding. So what is bodybuilding modeling industry? And how can it be organized, more organized, and can get more eyeballs from people?
Yeah. Actually, bodybuilding and modeling, it is not going on so well. Because bodybuilders are little huge.
Yes.
When they want to act or modeling with a girl, they look too big. Too big. So, but some people get, depends on the product. Now, suppose Ambuja Cement, if they want to show it is strong, so they take a strong man.
Right.
But there are a few products like that. So there is very few bodybuilders has model done sometime, but not, they cannot depend on that profession. Nobody has taken that as a profession. Or even films, some bodybuilders have only 8-10 bodybuilders have worked in the film, but small roles where they require a strong man or like that. But in bodybuilding, we have started now. One apart from bodybuilding, we have another category also. We call it model physique.
Okay.
Model physique we have started. Mm-hmm. But they have different rules. There's good physique, 6-pack, 8-packs. They have thighs. They may not have very big, and chest may not be very big, but good square chest, good body. We have started. We have got that for men, women. It is for both.
Right.
But still. Number has increased now, competitors, the number has increased, but they are transferring to modeling. It is not yet gone. Yeah. I'll give a new word to this. There are in between people in this, those who are doing exercise, we call them lifestylers. Lifestylers means what? They want good physique. They don't want huge physique. 6-pack, good waist, good chest, which you see on the beach. Running on the beach, playing with men, women. Women also, narrow waistline, good chest, have good leg, but, and they can wear bikini. A man can have in his short. Like that, we have another lifestyler. So they go for not much heavy. Good physique. They want to shine in this world. They want less stress. They want to become model, or they want to become rich. They want to, any field. It may be IT industry. They'll go in that. They'll go in movies. So that there are different lifestylers are there. And what happened? All not bodybuilders, as you said, why they can't go to modeling. You require acting also. Modeling also is not easy.
Right.
You know how to pose also. When a camera comes, director doesn't have long time to talk to you.
Yeah.
Once he says, please lie down and look at that girl. So I should be able to look that my acting and let love towards the girl I have to show. That bodybuilders and this, they have not learned that.
Right.
So a lot of photographers, a lot of model people, they tell me, sir, we can take them, but they don't know that that's how to present themselves.
Correct.
Like, it is not acting only, but in the eyes, anywhere, it's a movement, that's stiff.
Right.
So they don't move.
So
that's why. But it is going to change. Okay. But their lifestyle, just I'm telling you. Now see, Jackie Shroff's son.
Correct.
They go to acting. See, most of the actors now, they have good physique now. It has changed the industry. Now Dilip Kumar days are gone.
Yes.
Now every actor, hero has got good physique. Most of them. Even villain.
Yes.
Even villain, even comedian.
Yeah, I think villain have got better physique than the...
Yes. That picture, which is Bahubali.
Yes, Bahubali, yes. So one more thing is something that bodybuilding industry is very much goes along with taking supplements and everything.
Yeah.
But is it something that is you can't do without supplements or and the harm... Yes,
supplements, you're talking is supplements. I also take supplements. I'm talking. You're talking about drugs and steroids.
Yes.
Now see, a simple whey protein. Anybody can have.
Yes.
Why? There are egg powder is available. Eggs. Egg powder is available. Tin egg. There are protein powders are very good quality from Japan, from America, from India. They're good. That you can have it. But the steroids and drugs, especially, enhancers, body enhancers, they're really bad. And every bodybuilder, I should not say, because I'm there with them, they take it. They know life is short. Means bodybuilding life itself is also short. You can't remain bodybuilder for a long time.
Correct.
So they want to shine in a short time. So when a short time is there, you require so many. And they have learned from America. They have learned from foreigners.
Yeah.
Like that. Why? Arnold himself has taken. Or might be taking also now.
Wow.
Now, look at his face. He's not that as good as, of course, I've met him once only. He's a different person out of this world. But still, they take it. In Bombay also, our Mr. India, there is dope testing. Government is taking all the care. But they have got anti also. Now, it has come. I take for 3 months, 4 months, I become nice. I stop for certain time. I take something else. So it doesn't come in the test. So there are so many things. And you will say underhand dealing also goes. Oh, he's American. So dope test different. They take somebody's urine sample. All things go on in this also.
But
it is not a good thing. And it is very harmful for their future life. If you ask him, where are the old bodybuilders? I don't see in India my former bodybuilders. Where I don't see them. They have come from me. They have come under me. I have seen them growing. I don't see them now. Are they old, thin, completely spoiled?
So I think this is a very good
wrong thing.
Very good message to the new generation who is getting into it. I think work on your body with supplements and a good thing, but don't get into the vicious cycle of...
But what happened? He doesn't want to be 10th now. Doesn't want to become 5th. He wants to become 1st. But 1st takes no. So that 2nd one, 3rd one, he also feels like that for short duration. And there are experts, there are doctors advising them. There are coaches. Why Olympic, they have taken dope,
yes,
weightlifters and on many games. Why?
Yes.
They find cricket now also. Why? They are wise people, even cricketers are wise, their coaches are there. But their coaches also tell them. And then they take, oh, by mistake, I took it. It was my cuff, my throat, so I took that wrong. Like that they tell. You must have reading all the time.
Yes.
All the games it is entering. It's a big, huge market.
There are
better marketing from them side, their side also.
Correct.
And they name it supplements. It is not supplements actually.
So what needs to be, so now so my question is mainly from the athlete's perspective who are into sports, multiple sports, and fitness has become like what Virat Kohli has shown now.
Yes, a different level of
fitness, the way the jerks that he's doing and kind of heavy gymming he's doing to have his body. I think
that clean and jerk.
Yes.
And jerk, they show.
Correct. So, what needs to be done to stay fit for these athletes? What do they need to do? And is it only physical or the mental also plays a big role?
See, should I tell you, when you do fitness or exercise, you think it is exercise. Along with that, it goes there, diet, nutrition also, the rest period also. And you cannot separate mind and body. When you do exercise, what they were before, after exercise, they are better mentally also, physically also, comparatively. Now, if he's a worker, he cannot become as intelligent as Ambani, or Ambani cannot become like him. So that is different. But he improved what he was before, after exercise, he is mentally also, he improved because exercise. The breathing, the lifting, and focus, concentration with the mind, wiseness of selection of exercises. He become so wiser. You don't know our Mr. India, these bodybuilders are so wise. What to do, when to do, how to breathe, what exercise I should do. My lower body is weak. How can I make it more proportional? Even taking supplements, and as I said, steroids also, they are very wise. I've seen some people in the morning when they are tested, I mean, physique, morning, pre-judging we call it. Evening is final. Pre-judging, they are little different. In the evening, when the exhibition starts, the last 10 they want to select, they within 8-10 hours they change. Wow. Sometimes they take diuretics, more definition. Doesn't matter, they go 10 times to bathroom. But it was so clever, so intelligent. So that means brain is there.
Yes.
They may not use that brain elsewhere. That's why people think they are not, because they don't use it. They have better brain than all others, but they use it their own. Focus. But if he starts using somewhere, he'll become a wiser than others and what he was. For example, I'll tell you, they say, bodybuilders are so heavy, they can't run like an athlete. He may not run like an athlete, but he will run faster than any other person, normal man who is complaining or who is grumbling.
Yes.
It is like that. So yes. It's all around this bodybuilding. They are wise, intelligent. Only thing, they don't use that. That is the only thing. But when they open their own gym, when they change their profession, they become wiser and nicer. Really, I'm telling you. So you cannot separate mind and body from each other. Plus, you have to cultivate reading, observing, all things, meeting people, talking to them. You have to develop your brain. I attend so many inspirational talks in my young age. So many lectures, even I've seen delivery, a woman delivering a child, how it comes, what God's magic it is.
Yes.
I've seen visitor operations, heart operations, stomach operations, fantastic. Lungs, smokers, now how the smoker lungs and non-smoker lungs, what a difference there. So you have to study, you have to work upon, but brain is there. It is common for everybody. The brain is intelligent. You have to make it nice. Polish it.
Excellent. So I have just last two questions.
I'm sorry, I'm talking more.
No. That is what it is. That is what we need. I need more and more from you, sir. That is what our viewers also need. From the regular gyming, from Akhada, Mallakhambh to regular gyming with weights, it has come to then the functional training came, then the high intensity came. So, a lot of changes have happened.
Cross training.
Then that something that crazy, that insanity kind of training that was a fad in between in the US. So, how has this thing changed? And if somebody wants to enter this industry as a professional, not as a fitness guy, but as a professional, like a sports management student.
Like us.
What, like you, if they want to be an entrepreneur. So what is the message that you want to give and how the industry changes? And do you think it will come back to the cycle, that it will come back to the weights and the Mallakhambh again, the way bell bottom has come back into fashion?
It will not come back, but that dumbbells will remain like our basic food, rice, wheat, vegetables. Even if you go to Chinese or any lettuce foods and all those things. But at our home, that basic rice, chapati, dal, or whatever it is, a fish, a non-veg, I'm a vegetarian, water, they'll remain. Coca-Cola might come, other thing, everything come, but water will remain. Like that, dumbbells in the different shape, different design, different color, rubberized, it may change the look, but it will remain. And I'm telling you, lifting weights, it will remain forever. They may be different shape, different design, different angles, machines. It will change. And I'm telling you, cross, most of them are marketing people.
Yes.
They want to bring new things and showing people, oh, this will help you. This is functional training, different name. Now Zumba, now aerobic, different name. There is some tabo or something, some different dance. All are dances only, different music. Yes. Zumba and aerobics, same. But the Zumba people say, you don't need those dresses. The fashionable dress. You can wear any dress. You can, a housewife can do in the sari also. Because Indian women, they may not wear that slack. Elder.
Yes.
Music, you need not have that English music. You can have your Bollywood music. So, but movement is that. Move the body, dance. So they're all same thing. Exercise also. Functional training, these are new ideas. They are really good. We require, but it was there. Now cricketer, he need not do all the exercise what bodybuilder does. Cricket has to do different. The boxer, the Mary Kom, she does different type of exercise. Cricketer, of course, you may say they are weights, but the way you breathe, the way you do exercise, the, how much weight you take, what exercise you should select. For your now a certain throw, so throwing exercise, there are equipment for that. You have to and that we call it functional. But now latest things have come, like that. How foods have changed, hotels, Japanese food, Italian food, Chinese food. Now Mexican is becoming popular. In between, I'll tell you something. This is nothing with the food, but they ask, what are those black spots on the moon? Udpi people tell that Udpi hotels. I tell that Kalwalkar gym. Like that. So their changes will be there and people will accept and new generation will get used to that only. You know, my son now, little different. My grandson, he'll be little different. And they'll be automatically with the latest thing.
Right.
Like that.
Excellent.
And I also like to learn. Latest thing. I may not all the time adopt.
Yes.
I may not like certain things. But learning, yes. Every day I learn.
Yes.
And you talk about the business, something you're talking.
Correct.
New man can have a small gym. He need not have much investment. A small garage type or a 200-300 square, a personal one-to-one personal studio. Whole day work, morning 7 to evening 9. He takes about 10 to 12 people, either individual one-on-one or one to group two, group three. He can adjust and limited good, beautiful equipment, nicely kept. He can easily earn very well a small place, 300 square feet.
Very well, sir. Very well, sir. Yes.
My father used to do personal training, but we never used to call personal training. We used to call private tuition. Like that. Our time name was private tuition. We used to go house.
Right.
My father used to go to 8-10 houses. I used to go when I was in studying after building good physique from my gym. I used to go to 12 people. My private tuitions I used to do. That time salary was 125 per month. I used to get 3 days a week, 1 hour, like that. And you'll surprise what I'm sitting in this house. It's a beautiful house at Juhu. About 1500 square feet flat, myself, my wife only, but my daughter has come and her son Karan. A nice house. I bought it in on this personal training business.
Oh, wow.
On private tuition,
yeah.
Like this. But that time it cost me only about 25,000 rupees. Now it is 6 crores. Like 55 years back.
Yes.
And I'm staying very happily.
Yes, and if you put a Kalwalkar's name on top of that, I think there will be extra brand value as well to that.
Yeah.
So last question, as with the current pandemic happening and the fitness industry is one of the biggest industry getting impacted. It's not only as a business, but also the athletes are not able to train. They are not able to, like, this year Olympic got postponed. So a lot of things are happening. So how do you think the fitness industry is going to change post-COVID? I personally believe this is temporary. This is not a permanent thing. But
yes.
What you think is how it's going to change? And what are the opportunities which are going to come out of because of this?
Yes. First, I'll tell you the damage. First thing I'll tell you, definitely 30 to 40% gyms will close down because of its postponement, rains. It will close down. Small gym, big gyms also, too big also, too small also, they'll close down. And within 1 year, there'll be big problem for each and every small, big, like all other industries.
Yes.
All is an industry limit problem. But after that, I'm telling you, now people have started, I feel so, that thinking that exercise, immunity, they want to find, or they want to become successful, because they have time to think now. They're thinking. So that percentage of people that want, I would like to tell you 2 minutes only. The percentage is, India, I said, it is 0.0621. 1 to 1.06, you can say. But Europe, it is not Europe, America is 15 to 20%.
Oh.
And Europe, it is 20 to 24%. China is also more than us. So if that percentage goes up, whole industry will prosper. And more people will become healthier. Now, our Prime Minister Modi is saying that, what to call, not only Atmanirbhar, Arogyadayi Bharat.
Yes.
So for that Arogyadayi Bharat ke liye, they'll have to do exercise, and this will change. This industry will change within one or two. It may take next 2-3 years. Plus, home people doing at home, that home equipment business. I already started manufacturing. I wanted to, but it is not here with me. It is in my office. Lightest dumbbell, first time in the world. There is no such dumbbell in the world. Just put the print, weight comes out.
Oh, wow.
And also, it doesn't become too long. There are some different ways, but they are too long. They touch while doing exercise side. I've done a compact. I've done iron shoes for leg extension, leg. I'm doing it for every part. I'm to new machines I'm making, designing, planning, and they will come out. I've already taken your Punevan showroom near that hinge, that flower.
Right.
That their address building is their address. Front only, I've taken showroom for home equipment. So home equipment market is going to increase, supplement, food market. If food is food, health food. Health food market is going to increase, home equipment, gym equipment, fashion wear, exercise wear, literature, academy. There is going to change, and fitness industry has got a good future. Those who begin now, they will see. At present, they are all nervous.
Right. Understood. Yeah. I think mainly because of the high infrastructure cost, the size of the rentals, and all those things probably might be the tough. But what you said makes a lot of sense, that it will fail. So that's going to be the need of the hour.
But next, within 1 or 2-3 years, next, it will change. I'm going to change it.
Excellent. So, and you have changed so many things for India, Indian gym industry, Indian fitness industry. I'm sure you will be the flag bearer when it changes. So last thing, any message from your side for the young entrepreneurs want to come to fitness industry, or the athletes who are looking at bodybuilding as an industry, or the parents who might have some misconception about this industry, message from your side?
See, it's a wonderful industry. What advantage is what? Because you have industry, you yourself try to keep fit. That's the greatest advantage. I'll tell you why they join aerobics trainers, aerobics. Because they say they have not to pay the fees, and they teach also, and they get their own training also, 1 hour aerobics. So many trainers join for that. Even many people join, personal trainer, fitness training is different. Aerobics training, they have to move themselves 1 hour. So like that. So like that, my training that, keep it up, and live longer for your, as I say, see that you are going to live longer for your profession. Don't give up or don't neglect. I've seen there are a lot of gym owners ugly bodied. You must have seen. All many 80% of the gym owners are ugly body. Change that also themselves and continue to work. In the beginning, there will be a problem, and work hard. Keep yourself fit and go ahead. Now, parents, at present, they say, see, as it is, there, what their sons are, everybody is not earning very well, where they are got different life. But it should be not forced, not this line, fitness line is not forced upon. You cannot. It has to come from inside. But if somebody wants to come, the parents should support them, because they have bright future, better than ordinary clerk or working somewhere. This life will be better. He'll have, and what happened? When he shows results, he's like a doctor. When I show the result, when a person improves, it is ours is a prevention business. Doctor is afterwards curing. Ours is prevention. So prevention is better than cure, you know it.
Yes.
So this job, Baba, my son is going to prevent this thing. So he's as good as a doctor.
Yeah.
Like that. They should think that way, and they should support their kids or children to come in this life. My whole family, my son, my grandson, my brother's son, we are over 10, 12 workers, my daughters. Sorry, I'll just take 1 minute.
Yeah, no problem.
Now, my grandson, Karan. Yeah, and his my daughter's son. We have given them new logo, not Tarvalkar, FLC, Fitness Legacy Continues. Like that, they have got logo. And side somewhere they put Tarvalkar. But now, last 1 year, we have removed Tarvalkar and FLC has become popular at Juhu. It is very well-known branch, my current manager. Now my other two sons, they are not using Tarvalkar because it's a limited company. They are using T-Walker. There's a different logo, T-Walker. They have got two branches. And if people know T-Walker means near Tarvalkar. Fitness Legacy means which is Legacy, Tarvalkar.
Yes.
They have got two branches now, just 2 years old, at Malad and Nagpur. We are going to expand that also. I'm going to expand equipment also. I had an academy also. We had. Now we are going to start an academy also.
Wow.
So we have got big plans. And for that, I have decided to live very long.
And sir, you will. And we have all the wishes of the nation from like there are with you. I think you are a great role model to probably, I'll not say few, many people that we have. And it's such a privilege talking to you and really appreciate your time. Your blessings are very much required for parents to understand what the industry is, for people to look at how the industry is. Don't look at the short-term solution, look at the longevity, and love yourself and live your life.
Yes. Thank you, Siddharth.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. And God bless you all and those who are hearing. I don't know how many, but give my regards to them. And
yes.
Siddharth, I'll continue to take your help.
Yes, sir. And that's my pleasure, sir. My pleasure. At any
and
any
give
time.
My regards to your parents.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Take care.
Thank you. God bless.
Yes, sir.
Bye.
Bye.